Hi everyone, welcome to Newcastle Fans TV. So I'm joined by the other two presenters here, and we've actually won comprehensively 3-0, which is absolutely mint. This is going to go out on Facebook, so if you're watching on Facebook, head over to our YouTube channel because we've got a lot more videos coming up. And of course, if you watch on YouTube, stay tuned tonight because there's loads more. So, Shorty, I'll talk to you about Kennedy because everyone's going to be talking about his performance today. Mint, wasn't it?
Absolutely fantastic. He's showed his true potential. You know, this guy's got talent in Chelsea. You know, you don't play for Chelsea if you're not good enough, you know, and he's a good player with potential. I think, you know, under Rafa, he's getting a lot more game time and he's getting a lot more confidence. You know, he's played under 52,000 fans and he showed that today. And, you know, for his first goal, that touch was fantastic, wasn't it? And, you know, he can only go on and get better from you.
I don't want to sound too negative, but are you concerned about his fitness?
No, not really, because I think he's lacking fitness because he rarely played for Chelsea, but because he's playing a lot more for Newcastle at a higher level, I think...
Even though he's a professional.
Yeah, but I think when you don't play as many games, but you're playing at the top level for a team that's just come up from the Championship, it's always going to be a tall order. But he seems to be taking any stride, you know. He's playing with confidence. And when you play with confidence, that goes into the team, and the team has shown that, and that showed in the result today.
Cool. At least that talked us through the game. I'll hand you the mic. What's your thoughts on that?
Overall, it was brilliant 90 minutes. We didn't start panicking and doing what we normally do. When we get to that 20-minute mark and we switch off, it was just a brilliant all-round 90-minute performance. You know, if you say players that had a bad day still had a good game,
Yeah. That's
what we'll want to hear. You know, Southampton give loads of opportunities as well. You know, they're in a really bad state. But overall, brilliant performance today, and I can't fault any of the lads' performances today.
Fantastic. So, this 3-week break is coming at the wrong time again. I was saying to you earlier on, Charlie, that when we beat Man U, it was 2-week break, two away games, and now we've got a home game. It's bad timing, isn't it? Because you want that game to come quick, don't you?
It is, because the morale's up as well, and you know we're clear in the relegation zone. And for me, there's not a great deal you can do about it. Obviously, Tottenham was the original fixture. That's been moved because of FA Cup commitments. Like Rafa says, there's not a great deal you can do about it. I mean, it's out of our control now. At least we'll know, you know, if results go for or against, we'll know what to do against Huddersfield Town in 2 or 3 weeks' time. And again, it's a team that's just come up with us. It's a winnable game for Newcastle, and it's just the way it's fallen, unfortunately. But you trust that Newcastle can go on and beat Huddersfield in 2 weeks' time, and if we can do that, then I think we can be safe.
So, job's half done, isn't it? Everyone's talking about these two games being crucial and all this sort of stuff. We need those 6 points. We need those 6 points because the game's coming after that. A job half done?
I think so. I'm getting pretty confident now because it's not just us winning that's giving us an advantage. The teams below us are starting to play. You would have thought they'd be picking up form, trying to fight, but West Ham are getting beat 3-0. And you've got Leicester beating West Brom 4-1. Like, it's like they're not even putting up a fight.
The draw went our way.
Yeah, it's like half these teams aren't even putting up a fight. So, you know, hopefully that works in our favour. But at the minute, it really is. And hopefully, I'm confident we're going to stay up this season.
Are you confident as well, Shorty, that we'll stay up? I mean, I thought even if we got 4 points, I'll take it. But, you know, are you more happier now that we're in a higher position?
Well, I said it a few weeks ago that I think Newcastle will be safe before we play West Brom, and that's at the end of April. I think we'll get the points that we need. We just need to take each game one at a time and focus on the performances on the pitch, and if we could do that, I think we'll be absolutely fine. I mean, you know, lately the performances have been brilliant, and, you know, the Bournemouth game was a little bit disappointing that we couldn't get the 3 points there, but, you know, we've got a point in that they all add up at the end of the season, yeah. And we're not conceding as many goals now, which is great, and that just goes to show what Rafa's doing on the training pitch. And just again, a good all-round performances. You know, if I could say any negative, we're going to go 4 or 5, but that's just me picking up a negative. But we're winning a game, and that's most important, and we made, you know, Southampton look ordinary today.
Yeah, is our goal difference going to keep us up, do you reckon?
I hope it doesn't come down to that, but it possibly could, because you never know when teams are going to pick up form. But the minute, looking at the table, looking at where we are, looking at the teams below us, I think by the time we're coming to play, you know, the likes of Chelsea, I want us to be safe by that last game. I don't want to be going into Chelsea, goal difference could keep up. That's not what I want, because you don't know at what point are Chelsea going to still be fighting to get Champions League. You don't know what's going to be happening. So I want a few games in advance to be safe.
Yeah, I totally get that. Right, so everyone's absolutely out of the moon. Fantastic win, 3-0. Let us know what you think on your comments down there below and on YouTube. See you later. Bye-bye.